Let's take a trip back to the good old days. The days where you would come home from school, rush to get your work done just so you could have as much time online as possible. You turn on your Xbox 360 and check to see who else is online. You invite your friends to a party and start up Call of Duty Black Ops, hop over to the Zombies mode and load up a match on Kino Der Toten. And then...
Oh joy! No power!
Alright, what is going on, guys? It's Taz here, and welcome back to the channel. Now, what I've got for you guys is something pretty fun coming off the heels of the Black Ops Cold War Zombies reveal. I thought it would be fun to kind of go back in time a little bit and tell you guys the story of how I first got into zombies with Black Ops 1 on Kino. So I threw together this little video essay to kind of tell you guys about how I got into the zombies community all those years ago. So without any further ado, guys, let's just jump right into the video. You spawn in a dark, creepy, abandoned German theater, solo or with your buddies on round one, as one of the four main characters, Tank Dempsey, Dr. Edward Richtofen, Nikolai Belinsky, or Takeo Misaki, with nothing but a shiny M1911 pistol. It's just you and your gun against hordes of the undead. Do you save up to buy a door, another gun, wait to hit the box? Do you convince the player with the most points to buy that first door up on top of the stairs, or do you take one for the team? Are you playing solo and the first purchase is that ever important quick revive right behind the counter? Whichever way you play, you're in it for the long haul. First order of business, find the box and spin for a better weapon. Then it's time to go to the stage and get that power on. But when round 7 rolls around, it's time to hunker down in a corner and fend off against the hellhounds. Wow, that was scary back in the day, but at least now you have a max ammo. You shout into the mic, "Max ammo, everybody reload!" And then you're back in the fight. Time to link those teleporters and build up enough points for pack-a-punch and perks. When it's time, it's time. You drop everything that you're doing and haul ass up to that main teleporter. You then find yourself up in the projector room, safe for just a little while you upgrade your guns for 5,000 points each. It's not much, but it's a brief reprieve from the chaos of Kino Der Toten. Spawning back into the Cinema of the Dead on the teleporter pad in Spawn brings you back to where it all began, and then it's time to make a decision. Do you test your luck running around the map, fending off against the undead, picking up any extra perks you may come across? Or do you and your squad decide to camp it out and see how far you can get? My personal favorite spot was always behind the counter in Spawn. But as you fly through the rounds, these zombies only get stronger and larger in number. Eventually, Nova 6 crawlers are added into the mix, more dogs every few rounds or so, until suddenly, you're overwhelmed. One player goes down, another who was just trying to revive the first, players 3 and 4 split up, running from the zombies. The undead finally overtake player number 3, and it's all up to you now, player number 4. You try out this new method you heard about online, it's called training. You take the horde of zombies to the stage and start running them in circles around the podium. It's actually working, but not for long. You take those final hits and go down, game over, and the cycle continues. Back when I first got into Call of Duty Zombies all those years ago with Black Ops 1, I didn't care or even know much about the storyline or the lore or how Kino connected to any of the other maps. I just wanted something fun to play with my friends after school, and that's exactly what Zombies was. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't intrigued or even a little freaked out by all of the time travel shown off in the loading screen, the creepy teddy bears and hellhounds, all leading back to the mysterious Samantha, who was in control, but while I loved the mystery, it was never the main reason I decided to spend my free time mowing down waves of the undead. Mostly, it was just about getting to high rounds and having fun with the boys. It wasn't overcomplicated like we've seen time and time again in more recent CODs, it wasn't oversaturated, and there was no burnout, only wanting to survive just one more round. So the reason I decided to make this video or talk about how I used to play zombies is because of the reveal for Cold War Zombies that happened recently. It looked super fun and reminded me of why I started playing zombies in the first place. It was never about crazy multiverse stories or insanely intricate Easter eggs or any of that. It was just about playing a simple game mode with only one objective: survive. For those who don't know, I started my Call of Duty journey with Call of Duty 3 on the PS3 at my grandparents' house. My brother and I would play the same couple of campaign missions over and over again whenever we were there. We weren't very good, but it was fun. Eventually, we got an Xbox 360 and Halo Reach, and that was the main game we played for the longest time. But then I heard rumbles at school, tales of a secret Call of Duty game mode, the Elusive Zombies. After annoying our parents for long enough to get Black Ops 1 on the 360 over a year after its initial release, Zombies was the first thing I tried out when I got the game, and instantly I was hooked. Now, unfortunately, I don't quite have as big of a connection to as many of the DLC maps as I never ended up purchasing them until much later, so pretty much it was just the on-disc maps, mainly a lot of Kino, some 5, and Dead Ops Arcade from time to time. However, the one DLC I did end up getting was the Resurrection DLC. This thing was all zombies all the time, so naturally I played an unhealthy amount of Moon and the classic World at War maps, counting down the days until Black Ops 2 released with even more zombies content for me to sink my teeth into. Well, that didn't sound right. You never want to sink your teeth into zombies unless you're... Never mind. And with that, I hope Black Ops Cold War is able to in some way reignite that feeling I got from playing zombies back in Black Ops 1 or even Black Ops 2, and not to scare me away like it did in BO3 and BO4, with the focus shifted away from gameplay and placed more on the story and Easter eggs. Now, don't get me wrong, I love the zombie storyline and the characters and the Easter eggs, it's so intricate and that's what I love about it. But I feel like in order for Cold War Zombies to really succeed and go down in COD history in a similar way to Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 zombie modes, we're going to have to return to the game's roots, as to me, simplicity is key. And that is exactly what it looks like we will be getting from what has been said and shown off at the reveal, so I couldn't be any more excited for what Cold War Zombies has in store. But with all of that said, I want to know what you guys thought about this down there in the comments below. How did you first get into the zombies community back in the day? What was your first map and game that you played zombies on? And what did you guys think of the Black Ops Cold War Zombies reveal, and what are you most looking forward to in that game? I want to know what you guys thought about all of this down there in the comments below. But until next time, guys, it's been Taz, and I'll see you guys in the next video.